Welcome to Cambis School of Business and Motivation. On this channel, we talk about business, we talk about success, and we talk about motivation. We share knowledge. So if you are new to this channel, please slash the subscribe button to subscribe and activate the notification bell so that anytime we release a video, you'll be the first person to be served. So keep watching. Thank you. Welcome once again to this channel. This video seeks to draw some similarities and differences between coins and tokens. And as you can see, I purposely put the icon or image of Patreon token here. After some questions and research, I feel like we have to share some knowledge, dive into this, our token called Patreon. That keeps going down day in, day out. You withdraw $5,000, and when you go to swap, you find yourself with $100 or even less. So this actually made me to do some research and understand our Patreon and analyze it, deeply, to know exactly what it is, so that at the end we all conclude on a stance where we are with this token called Patreon. So if you are new to the channel, please subscribe, activate the notification bell so that you don't miss our next video. Well, pour nos amis francophones, cette vidéo va faire une comparaison entre coin et token, surtout notre Patreon token, jeton de sécurité de Patreon, fera beaucoup l'objet de cette vidéo. Bien sûr que nous allons comprendre ce que c'est que coin et ce que c'est que token, ce que c'est que coin et ce que c'est qu'un jeton. Nous allons essayer de voir ça et porter une attention particulière sur Patreon et voir si effectivement il y aura une amélioration positive de sa valeur. Voilà l'objet de cette vidéo. Donc si vous êtes nouveau à cette chaîne, s'il vous plaît, abonnez-vous, aimez, likez et partagez cette vidéo. Il y a des liens intéressants sous cette vidéo que vous pouvez utiliser. Et j'allais juste oublier, pour mes amis francophones, afin de réduire la durée de mes vidéos, comme je le faisais initialement, je fais ça en anglais et puis bon, après je fais une traduction. Et maintenant vous pouvez voir la traduction sous la vidéo.
Oui, vous pouvez voir sous la vidéo. Il suffit d'activer votre CC, le sous-titre de la vidéo, et ça va apparaître là-bas. Je crois que je peux vous montrer quelque chose ici. Voilà. CC, c'est ici. Quand vous venez aux paramètres ou bien réglages, CC sur une vidéo, vous allez voir ça ici. CC, c'est ça. À côté de paramètres. Settings, vous allez voir CC ici, Close Caption, Setting. Une fois que vous activez ça, voilà. Donc, par exemple, cette vidéo, je l'ai faite en anglais, mais j'avais fait une traduction en français. C'est ça qui se trouve en bas. Vous verrez que c'est ça. C'est ça. Vous voyez?
If you are new to this channel,
Voilà,
please
c'est en anglais,
smash
mais
the
la
subscribe button,
traduction est en français ici.
subscribe and activate.
Voilà, donc c'est ça. Il suffit d'activer votre sous-titre ici et ça va apparaître. Donc, vous verrez mes vidéos, elles seront en anglais, mais si vous voulez avoir la traduction, activez votre CC et vous verrez la traduction facilement en bas de la vidéo. Donc c'est ça. Donc si j'appuie sur CC, ça va disparaître. Vous avez vu. Si j'appuie encore, ça va apparaître. Voilà. Des fois vous appuyez et ça va vous sortir une petite fenêtre pour activer sur oui ou bien non. Donc c'est ça. Et merci beaucoup. Let's take it now from here. Difference between tokens and coins. So let me quickly read this. And after the reading, I'll show the summary of this. Then we'll look at something at Coinbase quickly. Then we come to the conclusion. Okay, here we are. Words coin and token are often used as synonyms and considered by many people as interchangeable, but they refer to two completely different concepts. So why many crypto users confuse coin and tokens, and what is the crucial difference between them? Good. In the fast-changing sphere of cryptocurrency, mass emergence of new terms led to misunderstanding of and misuse of them. All coins and tokens are regarded as cryptocurrency, despite the fact that many of them are not circulating as currency and were never meant to be. According to the definition, currency is a medium of exchange, unit of account, or a store of value. Bitcoin has all these features, so the name cryptocurrency is justified in this case. But all coins and tokens, the mass production of which started after Bitcoin's success, were named cryptocurrency by inertia. Though many of them do not fulfill necessary characteristics, so coins and tokens, two different kinds of unit created using cryptography, are named cryptocurrency. Good. This fact is misleading newbies. See here. But from here, is it all coins and tokens, the mass production of which started after Bitcoin's success, were named cryptocurrency. So all coins and tokens were named cryptocurrency by inertia. You understand? So this So this fact is misleading newbies that want to buy some crypto coin. And then find themselves happy owners of tokens. So you think you are taking coins, but rather tokens. So let's see now coins. Let's see the definition of coins clearly here. So coins that are also often called altcoin or alternative cryptocurrency coins are digital money. So coins, digital money, created using encryption techniques that store value over time. Basically, it is a digital equivalent of money. Bitcoin is the most famous example. Bitcoin is based on blockchain, public and distributed digital ledger, where all transactions can be seen. Data is stored collectively and shared between participants of blockchain network. Blockchain guarantees transparency and reduces fraud. There are coins based on Bitcoin original protocol, created by Satoshi Nakamoto and open to the public, Litecoin, Namecoin, and coins that operate on blockchain. Coin created with original protocol. The coin operates on blockchain. Specifically, these are Ripple and Monero. So coin have the same characteristics as money. They are fungible, divisible, acceptable, portable, durable, and have limited supply. Most ambitious crypto enthusiasts insist that coin will replace conventional money in the future. Now, the main characteristic of coin. They are tied to public open blockchain. Anyone is allowed to join and participate in the network. They may be sent, received, and mined. Coins are meant to perform any function beyond. Coins are not meant to perform any functions beyond acting as money. Tokens. Here we are with tokens. So tokens are digital assets. Really though, well, coins are digital money. Coins are digital money. Now here, tokens are digital assets. So already we have coin equal to money. So token equal to asset. That is it. Coins equal to money. Money as, I mean, liquidity as something that you can to exchange, buy things. So but coins, they are assets. Assets is simple as like something that you have that has value. Let's say if I take my car, I take my bicycle, I take motorbike, it's an asset. You understand? So coins, money, tokens, that is asset. So tokens asset issued by the project, which can be used as a method of payment inside project ecosystem, performing similar functions with coin. But the main difference is that it also gives the holder a right to participate in the network. So why is here coin can be have similar function like tokens can have similar function like coin. They are only used in a certain ecosystem. That is it. Certain ecosystem, certain network. It doesn't go beyond that. That is it. The main difference is that it also gives the holder a right to participate in the network. That is the token. So it may perform the function of digital asset. Again, asset. Digital asset represent a company share. Represent a share. You all know when we talk about share. When we talk about share, you know, like a company, you have your share contribution. You have some kind of right ownership. Okay. So coin represent a company share. Give access to the project functional and many more. With the launching of new projects, unknown facets of tokens functional are discovered. Ticket to a concert, for example, is a real life of token. Here, they are drawing the similarity of token to like a ticket. Like let's say a ticket, coupon. That if you can put it that way, you may use it at a certain time, at a certain place. You can't go to the restaurant and pay bill and pay your bill with concert ticket. That is, you can't take tokens to the restaurant or to pay for bill. Exactly, that's what they are trying to say here. Ticket has its value only at concert hall. Digital tokens are the same. That is it. Digital tokens are the same. They are like tickets. They are like coupon. You can just use it at a certain time, at a certain place. And that is it. Certain time and certain place. That is it. So follow me and then let's slowly go to our Patreon. So digital tokens are the same. They have certain use case only inside certain projects. That is it. At certain, as a certain place, ecosystem. So take it as if, like they say, ticket, coupon. I was talking about coupon. Yes, let's say a shop that gives you coupon. Yes, a coupon, they have value. They can put $100,000 on the coupon, $100, $200 on a coupon. Or a company that has a contract with a shop can issue a coupon. What that value, give it to you. So you are going to buy things in that shop alone with that coupon. You can't go to another shop to buy something with that coupon, with that ticket. Exactly. So that is what the token, their nature is. Now, tokens represent an asset or utility. That's what we read right now. So blah blah blah. Setting, creating a token is easier. Another thing for token. Creating a token is easier than creating a coin, as you don't have to create a new code or modify already existing one. That means for coin, creating coin is difficult. Anytime you have to create, I have to modify the code. But as for token, you don't need to modify anything. Just go ahead and you can reproduce. You just use a standard template from platform like Ethereum. Exactly, when you are creating token, so standard platform, standard template from platform like Ethereum that blockchain based and allow anyone to create tokens in just few steps. Using a template for creating tokens provides smooth interoperability, so users can store different type of token in one wallet. Ethereum was the first to simplify the process by creating a token, being not the last reason why tokens flooded the market. So summary, coins are just method of payment. They are money. They store value. You can use it to buy anything. Go to restaurant, pay bills, do this, do that. Why tokens may present a company share, give access to product or service, and perform many other functions. But note, within some ecosystem, coins are currencies that can be used for buying and selling things. You can buy token with a coin. Another interesting thing here. You can buy a token with a coin, but not the vice versa. That means you can take a coin to buy token, but you can't take token to go and buy coin. That is another thing. Coin operates independently, while token has a specific use in the project ecosystem. That is it. So if I can summarize all this, let me put it this way, simple. Coin and tokens. So coin, digital money, currency, where tokens are assets. you know, where tokens are assets. Good. The next thing is that coins are method of payment. You can buy things, you can sell things with it. But tokens, method, they are method of payment as company shares. Only company shares that give access to its product and service, and is only used in a project ecosystem. Now, you can take coin to buy token, but you can't take token to buy coin. Another one, coins are difficult to create. You need to change and modify the code. Anytime you have to create coin, modify, change the code, modify, change the code before you can generate a coin. But token are easy to create. No need to, I mean, modify, change, create anything. No, this simple template, beyond you go. Coins are like real money. Yes, as we read it, coins are like real money you can use to buy in the restaurant, pay bill, just name it. But tokens are just like real world tickets or coupons to be used for concerts or to buy at a certain place at a certain time. It can be used to pay bills or go to restaurant or do whatever. So the last is that coins operate on its own blockchain with its own protocol. Understand? So coin, they have their own blockchain and they have their own protocol. Meanwhile, tokens operate on other coins blockchain, just like we read it here with Ethereum, that facilitates the creation of many of them. You just use a standard template from platform like Ethereum. That is it. That are blockchain based and allow anyone to create tokens in just few steps. So you see, anyone to create tokens in just few steps. So they don't have their own blockchain, and no protocol. So you see, now we come to know, I think by now, and everybody gets where we are heading towards. So that is token. Now, our cherish patron token, CO, is a token and is running at the back of Ethereum blockchain. Ethereum, the blockchain of Ethereum, that is where it's running. That's where it's running on. And look at the value they just give the Patreon token at the beginning. $5,000. $5,000 as base price. $5,000 as base price. Good. So like I was saying, let's quickly see something here. So I was talking about the Patreon. $5,000 base price at the beginning. Meanwhile, running at the back of Ethereum. Ethereum itself is $2,000. It's not even up to 4,000, 3,000 since the inception. I think the higher was 3,000, 4,000, I'm not sure. But see, a token, in this case, security token, again, that we are going to see right now, the security token, what is security token? We talk about token compared to coin. Now we are going to see what is security token. That can be priced at $5,000 as base, while riding on someone's blockchain, that a blockchain coin itself doesn't have that value. Good. Let's look at something here in Coinbase. here, Coinbase, what is token? Look at what Coinbase shows here. Technically, token is just another word of the cryptocurrency, for cryptocurrency or crypto asset. But increasingly, it has taken on a couple of more specific meanings depending on context. The first is to describe all cryptocurrencies besides Bitcoin and Ethereum, even though they are technically also tokens. The second is to describe certain digital assets. You see, just like we read it right now in Google. Right now in Google. Yes, so they are saying it. The first, it's different, two different things. But yes, they put all of them as cryptocurrency. But notice that they put all of them as cryptocurrencies or crypto assets. I wish. That means crypto assets can cover all of them. Crypto assets can cover like coin and token. Because coin, you can use for so many things. You can use it as currency. It's an asset. Token is not currency. It's an asset. That is it. It's an asset. It's an asset, something you have that has value, but not money. So here again, Coinbase is telling us as two things first, describe all cryptocurrency besides Bitcoin and Ethereum, even though the two, like Bitcoin and Ethereum, technically they are also tokens. If in the technical sense, they are also tokens, they're like, yes, the way they created, they are also token technically, but they are currencies. So the second is to describe the certain digital assets. So token, first description, currency, token, second description as digital asset that run on top of other cryptocurrencies blockchain, just like what we showed right now. As many decentralized finance or DeFi tokens do, tokens have a huge range of potential functions, from helping make decentralized exchanges possible to selling rare items in video games, but they can all be traded and held like any other currency. So this just brief summary. So let's look at something here. Token is a word that you hear a lot in cryptocurrency. In fact, you might hear Bitcoin describes crypto token or something similar because of technique. That is it, what we read first. So let's see here. A token often refers, I think these are the two definitions, like the first description and the second description. A token often refers to any cryptocurrency beside Bitcoin and Ethereum, even though they are also technical tokens, just like what you read right now. Because Bitcoin and Ethereum are by far the biggest two cryptocurrencies, it is useful to have a word to describe the universe of other coins. It is useful to have a word to describe the universe of other coins. You know, so another word you might hear with virtually the same meaning is altcoin. Okay, now the other increasing common meaning of token. So here again, we see a token refer to any cryptocurrency beside this. So the other common meaning for token has an even more specific connotation, which is to describe crypto assets. Like I was saying, that the difference between them. One is currency, that is coin. It's currency. It's a store of value, and a token is assets. It is asset, something that you have, like company share, is something that you have that has value. Let's put it that way, that has value, but it's not money. You are now going to change it. You are now going to transform it into, maybe take something in return. That will now give you the currency. Now, with their capital asset that run on top of other cryptocurrencies blockchain, yeah, we draw that difference also right now. So you encounter this usually if you become interested in decentralized finance or DeFi. While a cryptocurrency like Bitcoin has its own dedicated blockchain, DeFi tokens like Chainlink and Aave run on top of or leverage on existing blockchain, most commonly Ethereum's. Yes, you read that one too. Yes, this is it. So tokens in the second category, that is here, the DeFi one. So tokens in this category help decentralize applications to do everything from automate interest rate to sell virtual real estate, but they can also be held and treated like any other currencies. So that is what they are describing here, like DeFi token. So let's see, here we have some few of them. The DeFi tokens, governance tokens, no fungible token, NFTs. Nowadays we hear talk about the NFTs a lot, and our master Petro, which is security tokens, is also here. So let's quickly read them and go to the next stage. So DeFi tokens, quickly, a new world of cryptocurrency-based protocols that aim to reproduce traditional financial system functions, lending, saving, insurance, trading, has emerged in recent years. These protocols issue tokens that perform a wide variety of functions, but can also be traded and held like any other currency. So that is DeFi tokens. DeFi tokens. Decentralized finance tokens can be traded, held like any other currency. You hear that? That is DeFi token. What is DeFi tokens? Then can be held as any other currency. That is DeFi tokens. It's not security token like our Petro that we so cherish it as if one day it's going to be it's going to tend to cut it. I don't know, it's going to get some value. Let's see. So DeFi tokens can be held like cryptocurrency, like money. That is it, simple put. DeFi tokens like cryptocurrency, money. Now, governance tokens. They are specialized DeFi tokens. They are also DeFi tokens, but specialized. That give holders a say in the future of a protocol or app. Or app, like application. So, which being decentralized, don't have board of directors or any other central authority. The popular savings protocol Compound, for example, issues or uses a token called Comp. This token gives holders a vote in how Compound is upgraded. The more Comp token you have, the more vote you get. So it is clear here. That is governance token. Just give the holders some authority, some power to decide or to vote in how they can decide the future of a protocol or app. That is it. Let's come to non-fungible tokens. So NFTs. NFTs represent ownership rights to a unique digital or real world asset. So ownership rights on a digital or real world asset. Simple. They can be used to make it more difficult for digital creation to be copied, shared, to be copied or shared. An issue anyone who has ever visited a torrent site, I'm sure you torrent site of the latest full of the latest movies and video games understands. Yeah, they have also been used to issue a limited number of digital artwork or sell unique virtual assets like rare items in a video game. Yes, that is it. So we see this one too. So the NFTs, that is their nature also. NFT. They are also tokens. They are also token. And they, what they do is that they give you ownership rights on a digital world, digital asset, digital artwork, like artwork. You know, and an example here is stolen. Where you go, I mean, that right make it difficult for someone to copy or share your creations. I mean, the digital creation, it makes it difficult for someone to do that. That is NFTs for us. Now, our patron, here is it. Here is its category, security tokens. And you could see that it's the last on the list. Security tokens. I heard about utility tokens. So, security tokens are new class of assets. New class of assets that aim to be the crypto equivalent of traditional securities like stocks and bonds. I know if you are not like I don't know how to say, you are not conversant with the financial terms and financial terms. Like when they say stocks, it's like share, it's like share, you know, share, just share, share, stock, share, like share bonds. They open at times, they can open bonds and they will say, okay, the bonds, they, you have to buy, it costs, the unit is this, you can buy up to this. So stock, share, let's take it like that. So they say their main use case is to sell shares in a company. Good. Main use case, when you are using security token, just it means that you want to share, you want to sell shares in a company. You want to sell share in a company. So like I was saying, stocks, yes, share. You want to sell shares in a company, very much like the share of fractional share sold via conventional market. Stock market, when you go to stock markets, that's what they are saying, that's conventional market, that stock market, that is shares. So their main use case to sell shares or other enterprises, for instance, real estate, without the need for a broker. So major companies and startups have been reported to be investigating security token as potential alternative to other method of fundraising. Good. So we see it now. Security tokens, they are like share. The main use is like sell shares. And now they are investigating it as another alternative, like fundraising. You know, there are many different type of fundraising or different method of fundraising. So now they are seeing it like it's being investigated as another way, another method of fundraising. So fine, this is where we come to with Patreon Pay security tokens. Now, my question here is, as a digital asset, we read that tokens are issued on a particular project, normally issued on a particular project. I mean, when we're reading the thing somewhere here, in a particular project, issued by the project, tokens are assets, digital assets issued by the project, which can be used as a method of payment inside the project ecosystem. So fine. So fine. This is the thing. So I'm asking, so our security tokens, which projects Petron Pay has issued the security token on? Because for all my understandings, all that we read, the summary I put up, what ASIPU gets from all this is that when you are issuing a security token, here is for a project. Because look, shares, so the main use is for sell shares. So shares mean that shares, you are selling shares. If I come to buy share, or you take my money and give me token, it means that you are giving me share. That is what is it. That is the meaning of security token. So Petron Pay, Petron Pay is taking our money. That is due. And give us security token. It means that they are giving a share. It means that we are taking share. And taking our money, meaning that they are raising funds. When they take our money and give their security token, they are raising funds. And they are raising funds for a project. So my question is that, what is that project they are raising funds for? What is that project they want to get shares from we for? What is that project, or where is that project? Because so far I've not heard about any project. I haven't heard for any project that is attached to Petron Pay security token. That is the whole problem. So if you can understand it that way, I think by now we should all know what is happening with our security token. Why is it going down, down? Is sinking? Like, I don't know. Just me, $5,000, and today, as we speak, if we check the value of, let's see here, if you want to check the value of the Petron Pay security token, you can come to Nomics, nomics.com. Let's see today the value. So for information, if you want to, you have some Petron and you want to exchange, you want to swap, before you do, you can come to nomics.com and you check the price of the Petron before you go ahead and swap. If you want to, you want to know the price of the day, or at the time you want to swap, you can come to Nomics, you get the price. So let's see the price here today as I'm making this video, 4th August, the Petron Pay price is $18.4 and let's see down here what is here. I think we should have some historical data here. Here we are, historical data. Today cry, it has gone up today. We'll see, right now is 1854. Yeah, that's what we saw just now. 1840. Okay, at this time it's 1840, but when they were closing the market, when the market was closing, that is 1854. So it opens this morning with 36 and close with 1854. So that is today, 4th August. Yesterday it opened with 18 and close with 34. Okay, that's why this morning is 36. Now today it close with 1854. So Monday, 2 days ago, Monday it opened with 19 and closed with 19. The 1st August, which was Sunday, 20 and closed with 18. 31st July, 14 and closed with 25. 30th, 12, 15. This is it. So basically, if you see all here, I think you see only Monday it went to 20, and by chance today it went to 36. But see how it closes here, 18.54. That is the value of the petrol. So I was just asking, like, is this petrol is going to get value one day? Is going to get value one day? The question remains, and that is the worry of everyone that has invested in petrol. Pay. You see, do we have to swap our small petrol, get some money, whatever it is, and then forget about petrol, or we should wait and expecting that petrol will get value and we can exchange it one day? That's the big question. That's a big question. So for me to answer this, or from my point of view, the security token must be attached to a project. You know, when it's attached to a project, then we know that, oh yes, it's going to get value. Like we read it, share, fundraising. So you are raising funds for something. You are raising funds, you wish security token to raise funds for something. Other than that, they were taking our money, giving us token, but no project behind, then it's another thing. It's a scam, if I can put it that way. Because when are we going to, for how long are we going to wait for the petrol to take value so that we can swap? There is nothing that is showing that can give us the assurance that Patron Pay or the security token Patron is going to get value. No, nothing. 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 So the way I see it is like, you know, if I can put it this way, they have a project. They have a project. And I think if that is true, Patron Pay should let us know. Patron Pay should come out to give people some assurance, some hope. Because, see, you have a project and you don't have money. You don't have money, and that's where you issue the security token. That's where you issue the security token. Some people can even call it STO, security token offerings. So you issue the security token to raise funds for the project, just like the definition said. So I'm putting it this way. So you issue tokens to take our money, to raise funds, fine. Now, if you understand it that way, or let me put it clearly for everybody to understand a bit. There's a project, let's say they want to build a city. They want to build a city, or they want to build a school. And they don't have money. But that school is a project that can be traded, that can be sold, or yeah, that can be sold for millions of, I mean, multiple times the cost. Now, they raise money, they raise funds for the project, and they give us what, in return, shares, like that is the token. So in normal sense, these are our tokens that is attached or that is endorsed on the project should take value, because people are going to run after that project. And because the token is attached to the project, is going to take value because people run after the token, the patron to buy the project or to buy the products or the service, whatever it is. But here we are, nothing like, I never came across any project that is attached to our patron. This actually prompt me to give my side this answer. For me, our patron may take value and may not take value. The question, if you ask me, patron, is it going to take value? My answer will be yes and will be no. And the no has value, and the no is I mean, simple, bigger. The no is bigger than the yes. Now, my yes is if only patron is endorsed on a project. And I want to quickly tip this in. It may sound like an advert for this company called Global Investment Trading. Liprima, one of their products, Liprima. But let's take it. It's not Liprima to say, but the Global Investment Trading itself that has a project. I don't know if, I know most of you would have heard about Global Investment Trading or Liprima already. You see, if you take their project, the SimCity, which they attach what? SimCoin to. Which they attach the SimCoin to. You see that SimCoin will take value, will gain value. Because see, I watch a lot of videos about GIT, Global Investment Trading, especially the SimCity, where they have, like in Accra, in Ghana, they have 250, I mean, the SimCity, 250 buildings to put up. So that's how come they issue the SimCoin. You know, they issue the SimCoin here so that, you see, they can raise fund. If I may put it that way, they can raise fund. It's like close to what patron pay should have done. So they will raise fund. And that they raise fund, and in return of taking the SIM, in return of giving your money, you take the SIM coin. So they take your money. It's like raising funds for the project, the SIM city, the construction of those cities, those houses. So we all know, when it comes to real estate projects, we all know the demand on the house. The demand on the house, we all know that. So with time, it means that that's a coin. It's not even talking. I mean, it's a coin. Right now, it's a coin because it's listed. If you go to crypto coin, it's listed. It's listed. Even that some stock exchanges, they are there. They are there. They are there on some stock exchanges. It's been listed. SimCoin is being listed. Here we have coin market cap. It's even here, Sipcoin. Sipcoin. Sipcoin is here. Unfortunately, if you tap Patron token, you will see Patron token here. If you tap it, you will see on coin market cap, you will see Patron token here. But you see, Sipcoin is here, it's listed. And I will show you how it's been taking value. So I was saying, so that SimCity that they are raising funds for in return of SimCoin, you see that by nature of the demand that comes with housing, you see that in the near future, all people, anybody that is going to like want to buy a house in the Sip City needs what? Sipcoin. Because Sipcoin is attached to the project. So before you go there to buy house, you need Sipcoin. And you run after Sipcoin. And Sipcoin will take value. Sipcoin will continue to take value. Let's see Sipcoin here. Let me see Sipcoin here. Sipcoin today, as we speak, 4th August, the value is $1.20. Let's see historical data of Sipcoin here. So, yesterday was 3rd August. High, low, and the close. So, yesterday they opened with 105. The highest in the day was 133. The low was 102 and the close with is 109. That is yesterday. 2nd August, they open with 104 and close with 105. That's why it's here. They open again with the 105. 1st August, open with 106, close with 104. And let's go down, down, down and see where they are coming from. CO, C. See, 4th June, 06, 06, see, 05, 06, 05. I mean, I'm sure when the Bitcoin drop and draw all the crypto assets down, that's where all this, they also drop down to 5555. But right now, as things are turning up, see, 06, 07, 08, 09, 104, 108, and today we are 120. Just from here, within some few months, June, from 4th June 06 to 4th August. So June, July. So 2 months, within 2 months, the Sipcoin has doubled in value, 0.67, and now we are 120. That is double. That is what I'm talking about. So Sipcoin, within 2 months, Sipcoin has doubled. That is 100%. Sipcoin has increased 100%. Double, because it's been attached to a project, and a project that in itself has value and increases in value all the time, because we know all know that a house, when it comes to house, is something that appreciates in value over time. So you see, so if you, for instance, someone invest, you buy like this Sipcoin, if you buy, let's say 100 pieces of Sipcoin somewhere beginning of June, which will be maybe $60 or $67, today it will be like $100 something dollars, That's what we are talking about. Just after 2 months, from $60, you have $120. Double the value. So this is what we are talking about. That's why I am saying that our patron, if our patron has to get value, I'm not doing this to discourage anybody or whatever, but I'm just drawing a reasonable argument that if patron will take value for me, unless it's attached to a project, there should be a demand on it. Because right now, nobody wants patron. Who wants patron? Nobody wants patron. Unless some few people who are just, they are traders. They want to see if they buy some put down wire, maybe to take value, and then they will sell it again. That's all. Apart from that, nothing. There's nothing that can drive patron forward, that can drive patron up. There's nothing. Absolutely nothing. You see? Another example I want to give, apart from Live Prima, another example I want to give is that, you see, well, recently, Amazon mentioned that it's going to accept Bitcoin as a way of payment. And that is, they are even preparing to launch their own coin. You see, so assuming Amazon launches their coin today, and Amazon is, we all know Amazon, and Amazon says that before you come to buy in my shop, before you come to buy, you need to get my coin before you buy. You will buy in my shop with my coin. Why not that coin or whatever it is, even if it's a token? Why is it not going? Is it not going to take value? It will take value. It's attached to a project. It will take value. And then immediately Amazon mentioned that it's going to accept Bitcoin. You see what happened the last few days with Bitcoin? From 29 or 28 or so, jump to 41. It is now that it has come down to 39 or 38 or so. So, that is my view. Again, apart from Amazon, there is this project of Facebook. Facebook is also going to launch. They mentioned that they are going to launch their own coin, which I call the name was something like Libra or Libra. Whatever it is, if Facebook today launch a coin or say a token that is issuing token to maybe support this project or do this project, we all know Amazon, we all know Facebook, YouTube, Instagram. That is it. And we know the service, the kind of service they offer. So if they issue a token and then they say, before now, before you do this, you ask for this product, this service, you must pay with this, our token or our coin, that token or coin, whatever it is going to get value. It will increase in value. It will definitely increase in value. But here we are. I don't even know. There is nothing. The people behind Patreon Pay, they are not saying anything. They are just there. So, that is my view when it comes to yes. And I was saying no, because no, and a big no, because there is nothing behind Patreon. No project so far, no project in itself. Honestly, I decided not to invest in any of these platforms again. See, I decided not to invest in this platform again. And I said it already in one of my videos that the best way to go now is to do the holding. You buy Bitcoin or you buy whatever cryptocurrency you want to buy or crypto assets you want to buy, you put it down, you wait, and it takes value, you sell it, you make some money, or you trade. And in definitely my next video, I'll come with a site where you go there, then you listed yourself. I mean, you have your own forex bureau, then you buy, you sell at your own time. So like I was saying, me, I decided to stop, and the only platform I decided to invest in now, and that will be my last stop also, it is Global Investment Trading, Live Playmark. Yes, that is my last stop. That is my last stop. Live Playmark, that is my last stop. I started already, and the gains are coming. I mean, every Friday, I mean, when you invest, 1 week later, you have your payout. So I've started receiving my payout with Live Playmark, and I'm okay for now, and that will be my last stop. Once, if it goes onward, which I know, I have confidence that it will go onward. If you do, well. If it doesn't do, anyway, that will be my last stop. And beside that, I think it's better we do holding or trading. And trading in your own way, your own manner. You be your own forex bureau, not this automatic trading, take loss, stop loss, take profit. No, not that. So please, like I mentioned, there are links down below this video, interesting links. You can click on them and check whatever you want to check, whatever you want to do. It will be very useful to you. Thank you for being with me. So for this one, it's been a long video, but I know you will take good, you take something meaningful, something good out of it going forward. So don't forget to subscribe. Thank you.